Hey guys, Sean Hamlin with PremierGuitar.com. We're in Nashville at Summer NAMM 2018, talking to Matt from Square Amps. Matt, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Doing well. We just saw Matt across the way when we were doing another video and saw these killer amps that you do. You guys are based in Austin, right?
That's correct, yep, Austin, Texas.
And everything you do, well, not everything. We're here to talk about your standard model, but you also do all these one-off things with stuff that you find at like flea markets and all that, right?
Yeah, definitely. I take all the radio guts out and build totally new amps inside, all new parts.
Now tell us kind of about the range of, even though all these chassis or whatever are kind of custom one-off, depending on what you find, you want to kind of tell us what most of your circuits are like?
Sure, I have three different circuit models. Most of them are sort of 5F1 based, like a Tweed Champ with more guts. I have another one that's like a Supro, early Supro based, all octal preamp, and another one that's sort of an early Vox kind of bass with the EL84.
And the Supro one has what again? Did you say six?
All octal front end.
Like 6973s? 6FL7s,
yep.
Oh, okay.
Old school.
Nice. And when you said that the Champ is like a Tweed Champ with more guts, you mean like more gain, not more circuitry necessarily?
Yeah, like a little more guts, sort of in between that and like a deluxe, you know, sort of like right in that sweet spot.
Okay, so you have the standard model, which is called what again?
It's called the Doyle Combo.
Doyle?
Doyle, after my grandfather, which is how I started doing this.
That's cool. And it's the Tweed Champ with more guts, right?
Correct, yeah, and I can put any one of those circuits in this guy.
So it's got 6V6?
6V6, correct.
And then just like one or two gain stages?
Just two gain stages, that's it.
12AX7 or?
12AX7.
In both of them?
Yep.
And then rectifier?
5Y3.
Cool. All right, so it's a one knobber, of course. When we came in, you had it pretty much going all out. Do you want to maybe show us some? Obviously, it's one knob. It's not like a multi-channel affair, but you want to show us?
Kind of clean it up a little bit, knock it down, clean up a little bit.
Turn it down for a little more headroom. Is that what you're doing?
Pretty much. And I also have a negative feedback control. It's on the back, sort of like a presence control. So you can, you know, if you dial that back, you can get a little more clean headroom out of it with more volume. So
you want to do that and play it for us?
I can do that, man, for sure. Let me.
Sounds nice, man. Now, at the beginning of that time around, it was a little cleaner. I couldn't see. Did you have your volume knob down, or were you just altering your dynamics?
I was altering my dynamics a little bit, and I turned the negative feedback all the way back.
So nice.
More clean headroom. So.
Okay, so a couple other questions on what you do as far as tubes. Are you just kind of doing current production? Or?
Normally, I do all JJs. I like JJs, but I do have new old stock. I have a lot of new old stock tubes, so if that's something that somebody wants, I can definitely swap those out. So.
Cool. So, and you mostly do Weber ceramic speakers?
I use Weber Signature Series for the radios, and this guy is the Legacy Series, a 10F150.
Cool. How much does the Doyle go for?
The Doyle goes for $1,200 shipped anywhere in the U.S., and the radios are $700 shipped anywhere in the U.S.
Okay, cool. You want to tell people where to go online to find out more about them?
I got a website, squareamps.com, and I'm also on Instagram and Facebook under squareamps.
Sweet. Thanks, Matt.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us, guys. I'm Sean Hamlin for PremierGuitar.com.